I wish there was a way I could not disappoint Germany and win the African front. That'd be so nice.
We can help with that. Here you go.
Oh my god, thank you so much. Now we don't exist.
Have you ever wondered what if Peter Parker never said, "It's pizza time"? That's what we're gonna answer today, because in this universe, there's no Mediterranean Sea, there's just the Italian Sea. Obviously, this peninsula's gone, and that means no pizza, and no Pope. Corsica, for some reason, is now just a random island in this even bigger inland sea than before. Also, Venice pretty much isn't gonna do anything here. Worst of all, without any Italian culture, that means there's no Mafia, which means no Mafia City. This truly is the darkest timeline. So without Europe's soft underbelly, what's going to happen? They don't even have an underbelly anymore. It's like they don't even have a dong. This actually started off as a Reddit post, and it is one of the greatest proposals of all time. I really think this would fix Italy entirely. EU4 devs, please consider this. I do think this is getting a little out of hand, guys. I mean, how many places are actually real? I guess we figured out that New Zealand isn't real, Australia isn't real, Finland, Denmark, Wyoming, now Italy. Can we somehow erase my virginity too? I guess theoretically, if this world was real, that would mean that Rome never existed. Which, I mean, we might as well just fucking throw these games away, because there are so many references to Rome. I'm actually really lucky that the Italians don't really watch me. They're like 17th on the list. 17th on the list of countries that view this shitty channel. I'm just really hoping they don't find this video, because I'm seriously the most hated man in Australia. Still, to this day, I get comments on my Australia is not real video. I'm Australia's most wanted. They're never gonna let me forget that shit. Oh, by the way, this is completely random, but if you wanna watch a video about roller coasters, I did that recently. Sometimes I just need a little break from the depression of map games. I need to do something else for just a second. There's a little link down below for that. I'm assuming Castile's just gonna roll straight over Aragon now, because they don't have Naples. They normally start off with, you know, a little bit of extra power over in Italy. Not this time. Spain, I think, is gonna form pretty quick. Actually, if they do it really fast, which that is fully what I'm expecting, the whole Western Hemisphere might just be entirely Spanish. I wouldn't be surprised. Which might mean that France is gonna have to surrender early. They might have to deal with a big threat to the south and the north, and who knows what's gonna happen with the HRE. It's still fine over here, by the way. It's still looking like a big old gangbang. Big old cluster. They're having fun over here. Oh, I guess the Pope is still here. I miss that. I forgot they had this territory. Okay, well, we will still maybe have, like, basically some Ulm Crusades. They're now Ulm. I didn't really think about this, but I went to the geography map mode, and this would definitely be the site to see. The Mediterranean and the Alps. Just massive difference there. Things are already going down in Iberia. Not a surprise there. I did notice that Morocco actually took this away originally from Portugal, then Castile took it back without giving it back to the Portuguese. Real nice. It also looks like France is gonna win the Hundred Years' War, or at least just kick, oh, yep, there, okay. The English are gone from continental Europe. Okay, now the Pope is dead. Okay, we've been going back and forth. They are for sure dead. I don't think he's coming back either. I feel like I've never realized this before, but is this region actually called Lower Don? We've got Polish Lower Don as well as Lower Don over here. Okay, I'm learning something new. I guess technically there might still be mafias with the Irish around. There's like Irish mafia, I guess. We'll see whenever the potatoes run out. That's a weird one. Not only is all of Iberia united against Morocco, but Tunis is also on their side. Some infighting, it seems. Oh, and it's only a matter of time. Okay, so Castile already has their partnership over Aragon and Navarra, and it's barely been just 50 years. That's scary. Which, you know what, speaking of unions, we do still have Poland getting lit, and Denmark, who actually just annexed Norway. I missed that one. Obviously Sweden kind of, yeah, they left, but we'll see what happens up here. Here comes this whole thing. So I'm guessing the Catholics will not have as much support, since the South isn't really here. Protestantism might completely take over. The first New World colony has arrived, and obviously we knew it was probably gonna be from them. So they're gonna be starting off in the Caribbean. This is the AI loves to do. And Portugal in Brazil. Wow, that is, that's a shocker right there. I can't imagine that. Portuguese, Brazil, what the fuck? Legoland is giving Sweden quite a hard time, as expected. At least the Swedes will now be able to play LEGO Star Wars A Complete Saga a little bit early. Kinda odd to see the Japanese not united. It is like 1550. They were doing it pretty fast in like previous EU4 versions. Poland and Lithuania just gave birth to the Commonwealth. That is a pretty monster baby. They actually might give Muscovy, soon to be Russia, a little bit of a hard time. Oh, and also Denmark lost Norway. Yeah, that That hurts. Not sure exactly how that happened. Maybe the Commonwealth had something to do with it. Castile's the only one down here in South Africa, and they have multiple provinces. Damn, already four, and no one else is even close. The Brits are focused on Newfoundland, and that is about it. They haven't made it any further south than just this. And it looks like the trans people are not going to have a very good time. Timmy's up here just, using just very offensive language. Barnacles, that is quite the Protestant expansion. I wasn't expecting that. There's not gonna be like any Catholics left, maybe just in Spain. Yeah, this is pretty extreme. Like entirely all of the HRE converted. Almost every single province, actually, yeah. Pretty much. Actually, there is a lot of reformed. I don't know how long this has been implemented, but I'm not used to these guys. I don't know what the Penguins of Madagascar are doing around here, but they can't just rename their whole country. I don't know if you could tell, but this is a whole lot of yellow. A lot of yellow in the Western Hemisphere. Spain has formed, and the Portuguese, the Brits, and the French aren't really doing all that much. There's a pretty scary thing forming right there in Iberia. And it looks like Ming is not gonna explode. That is depressing. That's like my favorite part about EU4. I thought it happened a lot. I guess it doesn't. This is, I guess, a little bit more normal. Japan, you guys gotta get together. I don't know what's happening. Oda is actually kind of making a comeback. Is that the Civ 5 dude? Pretty sure that's the Civ 5 guy. Okay. A little odd that this Italian trade node, or basically the Italian trade node, is still doing so well. I know that it tends to do well, but this is really ridiculous compared to these guys. For a second there, I legit thought there was a country just named Soy. Just Soy. I don't know. It's obviously on my mind, but damn. A little disappointed now. The Brits are surprisingly doing pretty well here in like Western Sub-Saharan Africa. They're kind of the only ones here. I don't know if they're kicking off other Europeans, but not bad. Of course, that doesn't really matter when you look at what Spain is doing. Yeah, they are just blobbing out, connecting territories. They're gonna have, I don't know, close to 10 colonies by the end of this. Looks like Austria is having a fantastic time without the Italians. They have just moved and taken everything north of the Alps. How can they do this when they're the emperor? The race for Australia has begun, and it's gonna be between just the Brits and the French. Obviously, there are distracted people in Iberia, so I don't think they're worried about this part of the world. Denmark, you good? You good? You don't look so good. What happened? Jesus. I don't know if it has anything to do with Eastern Europe, but there is a pretty big battle raging over here. Commonwealth, Russia, maybe even Sweden could definitely play, I think, a pretty big role. Ooh, and Spain, just moving pretty deep into Africa. Spanish Congo, Spanish East Africa. The French did get over here, although it looks like they're not doing very well. I'm actually just kind of shocked that Morocco ended up surviving, but not only surviving, they had a pretty good game. Took out a lot of these tribes out this way. Again, they started off really, really bad. The Ottomans are looking scary. They have been kind of dormant throughout this video. Wow, okay, so all of a sudden, they are looking pretty powerful. Denmark is now dead. They are completely dead. I don't think they exist at all. Even in Iceland, they've been killed by the Norwegians. You know, North America is not as dominated by the Spanish as I thought. There is still, you know, pretty good French, Portuguese, and British territories. Obviously, the South is, pretty, I guess, kind of expected. Timmy's turned into this dark, scary green monster, and they are actually starting to move a little bit into the subcontinent of India. Not sure if these guys are really gonna be able to stop them, but we'll see. The Brits have clearly won the battle for this territory, and it looks like Portugal did end up coming a little bit this way. Oh, the French just left. All right, so I guess there's a mixture of people over here. Again, this trade node is still not looking that bad, surprisingly. I mean, there is basically only Austria, and let's just call this Venice. That's some pretty good money. Okay. When was this possible? How? What the fuck? Ming is doing amazing. They are doing really amazing. Not sure if they're gonna keep that little territory over Europe, but they do still have all their hoes in Asia. As for the top four, I mean, the order is a little bit weird, but I figured, yes, Spain was gonna be number one. Wow, I mean, for a second I thought maybe they are gonna, you know, maybe lose out, but nope, that didn't happen. Here's one last look at the religions, and I guess the East is pretty typical, no big surprises here. Europe isn't as shocking still. I think we've seen something like this before. I like how it's divided, and then, yeah, the Western Hemisphere is a big mess, as it normally is. There's quite a lot of Mayans still around, which might be the first time anyone has ever said that. Turns out, you get rid of the Italian peninsula, and Spain remains the strongest nation on Earth. They don't ever, like, decline in power. All right, well, to protest, you guys should just stop eating pizza. Maybe also never play Mafia City again, too. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
A big thanks to Free Cruise, LVC, Destiny, 9000, Hen Papa Stalin of the Paintbrushes, Danko Franco, Mega Fat Boy, Elijah Senpai, Roosterification, Jen's Love Disc, Swiss Argo, Maxi G, King Solomon, Abraxas, Galley, Tanner of the Nazareth, Hatman, Cooter Donkey, Mr. Diddles Man, Brandon H, Beard Dunn 97, The Lord of Silence, Ben Whitson, Valencari, Jared Clarks, and Ben Moe.